Hi guys, Brookelynne, and welcome to the channel. If you're new here, thank you so much for stopping by. I upload videos twice a week, on Tuesdays and on Fridays. And if you're a current subscriber, thank you so much for your continued love and support of my channel, and I'm really hoping you're enjoying my content. So a big heart for you all. And today's video is gonna be my January and February 2022. Can you believe it? Like 2022 beauty favourites. So I think I've decided for this year, I could change over the year, but what I have decided is just do bi-monthly, so like January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, that kind of thing. May change, may not change, but that's what I'm going to do from now on. So I don't have such a pressure to get a favourite video out every month, because you know I've been late on them and I haven't even done that December favourites, and I'm just like raging at myself for not doing that video around the Christmas break, because I could have just done that like on Christmas Eve or something like that, or Christmas Day or Boxing Day, whatever. But hey ho, so I've got a good range of products because I did get a lot of makeup, and I bought a lot of makeup over Christmas. That's just me. And I did find some really, really great products I absolutely love, from hair care, tanning, bit of skincare, and makeup. So let's get started. So I'll start with the skincare. I've got one item which I've been absolutely loving and reaching for, and this is the Body Shop Strawberry Body, I think it's their souffle, body yogurt. It's like they're more kind of faster absorbing version of the body butter, so it's just good for on the go moisturization. And I do use this on my face and body, and it smells amazing. My sister got me this as part of a Body Shop strawberry collection for my Christmas present, and I just love this. Like, there's hardly any left. Kind of sad, but I've been using it a good lot from Christmas to like February, but I've been trying to hold off not using it so much, but and still look, it's empty. But the smell of this is like proper fresh strawberry. It's like a bit of body lotion-y too, but it's just beautiful strawberries, and it does really help to hydrate your skin and just make your skin feel nice and moisturized, because everyone, especially my skin's been distressed anything this winter, and I'm sorry, I keep on touching my hair, it's just one of them things, but I'm trying to get it set properly, because yeah. No, me probably end up having the hair like an appear for the whole video, but hey ho. But I do recommend this body yogurt. It's really, really nice. It moisturizes your skin. The only bugbear about it doesn't really like last. Like, it's only doing it like a month or something, because I have been trying to hold off using it. But yeah, it's so worth it. I love it. So on to tanning. So I've got one tanning product, and it is, of course, the Tilly Tan New Ultra Dark Tanning Mousse. This tan, if you haven't seen my review, watch it. Seamless plug over there, but hey ho, it's also to support this tan. So the lovely Absolutely Charlotte from Absolutely Charlotte sent me a list of review, and I said, of course, yeah, because I want to try the Ultra Dark Tan, and I was interested in getting this tan anyway. They do have medium dark and ultra dark, and I think it retails for like £13.50. It's all in the review anyway, and limits like £3 or £4, I think. So it's a good, affordable, like mid-range affordable tan, but the quality of this tan is amazing. It is proper ultra dark, and it does give you a lovely olive undertone. I'm doing another review of it again, but hey ho, I love that tan so much, so I'm happy to endorse it. So I've been wearing this non-stop throughout January and February, and as you can tell, I've hardly much left about up to here, I think I am on this, if I'm lucky. So I will be ordering again in the near future to buy this tan, but I just love it, and it dries really quickly, like, so you don't have to spend ages like that trying to dry your tan. And tan guide colour is Lauder, and it's like a nice good olive tone. and you can work when you go out. So if you want to do your tan the same day, just do your tan, stand a little bit like for 5-10 minutes and throw some loose pajamas or something on, get your makeup and all done, and or to go about your business for the day, get your makeup done, your hair done, and then put your clothes on for that night, and then your tan's ready pretty much. But obviously you have to wash off the guide color the next day, but it is a good guide color to wear out. Sometimes I find they just don't wear out really well because the guide color can look muddy, but this one actually looks a lovely olive tan color, so I would definitely recommend it. It's lovely tan. Enough said about that. I've just rambled on my tan, but I love it. I absolutely love it. So on to hair care, and yes, I do have two hair care products. So the first one I'm going to talk about is the Matrix Dark Envy Shampoo. This is basically a toning shampoo for dark hair, so very dark brown, like dark brown to black. So a level 4 to a level 1. A level 1 is black, a level 4 is like a medium dark brown. Technically a dark brown, but hey ho. So this tones your hair. It has a green pigment to it. I'm going to open it and just kind of show you, but I don't think you can see. I don't want to spill over my carpet or my sheets on the bed. But it does deposit a nice kind of deep, deep green pigment, and what that does is it just takes out any red brassy tones in your hair, which a lot of people who dye their hair dark, dye their hair black, can end up getting that nasty. Well, sometimes it can look nice, but it's really nice when you intend it and you like it, but sometimes the brassy red can look patchy. So this just gets rid of it. And I like it because it keeps my hair nice and black and blue black. So I do dye my hair every month, and this just kind of keeps the colour in. So it does, and I do vary between black and blue black for my hair, and this just works for both. I thought when I had blue black hair it wouldn't work because I thought it would change the tone, but my hair, I can show you. This camera's probably adding warmth because I had the warm light on, because the other lights kind of washed me out. It does look a bit warm in this one, but it actually does like look blue black in the proper light. Should I just put on the cool light to show you? I think I will. Okay, you can see it there. That's like the cool light on. You can see how nice and blue black that does look, but obviously it's making me look so pale. And then that's like just bright white or bright light, and that doesn't look make it look as pale, but it does still make it look pale, and doesn't look too bad actually. But it does show up the blue black as well, and obviously warm light can kind of still see, but it's warm so it doesn't show up as well. But you can see this doesn't affect the blue black in your hair at all, which is amazing. So it's safe to use on like blue black hair. I would recommend using the Sorry, I'm touching this hard, trying to get it to sit properly. I would recommend the brass off if you have blue black hair, because it does keep the blue black in your hair a bit longer, I would say. But this one just more kind of darkens it down a bit again, because it is like making your hair look darker, which is amazing. And you're probably thinking your hair is black enough, but you can't get any darker, but it does like banish any of them unwanted lighter red tones to do you until you dye your hair again. So I love it. I did buy this actually, like, not December last year, but the year before, so not last Christmas, but the Christmas before 2020, and I was using it on and off for a while and loving it, but I was keeping it until I used up other shampoos, and then I kind of just put it on the back burner. Because I did do my hair blue black for my wedding, and I bought the brass off, and I thought it was just too scared to use dark envy in case it would make my hair look green, like the blue black turn green. But since it kind of geared more towards the blacks, I just lifted this one up and fell in love with it again. Definitely is amazing. I absolutely love it. So the next favourite is this Dr. Pawpaw. It does it all. I think it's a 7-in-1 treatment styler. It says here, it's really hard to read because it's tiny writing, but that, so it's basically a knockoff of the Revlon Unique One or the Perfect 10. Similar kind of concept. It's like a thick kind of lotiony cream. You spray it on your hair, it does have a wee spray nozzle, and it's stinking with all the product on it, because it is quite thick. But you spray it in your hair. I spray it in my hair several times, not too much, but several times just to get it coated. And then I do that before blow dry my hair. Use a heat, I think it also have a heat protectant in it, but I do use a different heat protectant, just a few sprays a lot. Some blow dry cream and some oil like serum. Brush it all through, blow dry my hair with a brush. So basically just blow dry my flat brush, paddle brush. And it's actually an Arvent brush. Yeah, it's one of them or vent brushes, but just detangles your hair. And how smooth your hair gets is amazing. Like, I don't hardly have to straighten my hair. Because that, even with when it was like blow dry my hair straight, I didn't have it. It was more fizzier. But now, like, my hair is like literally like smoothed straight down. Like, I had it like this on Sunday too when I washed my hair last. Like, I washed my hair like today, but I washed it on Sunday. Do you always find you have to have the perfect amount of hair in the back and the perfect amount of hair in the front? You can never get it quite right. That's me. But yeah, I did blow dry straight on Sunday and today when I washed it today, and to smooth my hair. It's made me, my hair definitely a good difference. When I didn't have that and was just using the wee gliss sprays, even though they're good, they weren't making my hair smooth with this stuff. So I think this is like a couple of pounds from my Home Bargains. I would definitely recommend it. I just randomly went into Home Bargains, I think it was the other week, with my husband Connor, and I was nosing around the health and beauty aisle, as I do, because I take ages in Home Bargains. If you haven't been to Home Bargains, go, because it actually is an amazing shop, but I might get addicted to it because the bargains in there are amazing. So I spotted this in the hair aisle and I was like, might as well try it. Popped it in the pocket, or the bucket. Popped it in the bucket, got it, and then used it, I think, the first time last week, it was last week, and I was blown away. Like, you could probably get away with using this on your own, but because I've got quite thick hair, I like to use a good bit of product to get that smooth, conditioned shine on my hair, like, just nice. Salon fresh hair, like that's what I like, and this stuff does give me it. So yeah, okay, so on to the makeup, which last but not least. So I'll start with this eyeshadow palette. This came in my makeup obsession, the final countdown Christmas advent calendar. If you haven't seen my clips of me opening up the advent calendar, they'll be on my channel and they're in my vlogmas, but I don't think you want to see them now because it's like nearly late February, well pretty much is late February, but February's nearly over, so I don't think you want to watch Christmas vlogs at this time. Won't judge if you do, but that's what the palette looks like. It's a Dreamer palette and I have been loving it. It's a really good palette. It is like a good full-size product, yeah. It is a full-size product, but it is quite small in date for mirror, but not too small, not too big. It's a perfect size for like traveling, we have a little bit of extra room, or just grabbing for something on the go. Here are the colors, so it does come with nice kind of girly neutral and bright colors. Like, I love that champagne-y. Ooh, I love that. It's like a champagne color, like a creamy champagne, and it's beautiful. The shimmers are absolutely lovely. I did use this palette for my Valentine's Day look. If you haven't seen that, that'll be there too, but Valentine's Day has gone. I do like the gold, I love the gold, I've been using that non-stop, like, I've had a dent in that already. That's the gold, and I'll swatch it beside the champagne. Messiest swatch ever, but hey-ho, that's the gold. Now, I have tried better eyeshadow palettes, but this one's just been easy to reach for, and I do like the quality of it. It is good quality. And I do like that glittery black. That black's absolutely lovely. Like the pigment and all that black is amazing, and I actually have been using that as an eyeliner, believe it or not. And yeah, probably shouldn't have swatched that black. I'm kind of regretting it. Look at my hands, but hey ho. And what else? What do I like? I like that nice kind of lady chocolate brown. It's not going to swatch well because it's a matte, but it's a good one just to put in the crease. No, it's not swatching well. I tend to mix that with a cool tone one at the side. But yeah, that's the colours. They actually are really, really nice. So if you can't get this palette, would definitely recommend it. It's just easy on the go palette, and I love it just for grabbing for quick makeup looks, like I said, and creating some nice girly looks and also some nice like neutral natural looks. It's just a really nice palette, and the quality is good for drugstore, definitely. So, next product I have to show you is a base product. It is a famous, it's a mini size of it. It's the Charlotte Tilbury Hollywood Flawless Filter Glow Primer, Glow Booster. It's the wee mini size. I got ordered off Charlotte Tilbury's website like over a month ago because I needed to try it. I was like, I want to try this Glow Booster. I really want to try it. Do I pay the full price because of the mini, but I wanted to try it. So I ordered it. I think it was like £14, £14, which is a good wee price for that. And that's what it looks like there. And I will try to blend out. I got the shade 4.5, which is like a nice olive toned glow booster. We have several shades. That's what it looks like. It's a lovely, beautiful glow. Do have it on now if it's got a quick glowy base on, but it's not that one. But yeah, like I said, they have loads of shades from the very, very fur to very, very deep. I think they have like 7 or 8 shades, which may sound crap for foundation, but this isn't a foundation. It's more of a glow boost. I think they have 10 shades, come to think of it. But it's more of like a glow boosty product. You can use it on your own if you just want just something to glow your face up. Maybe a bit of concealer there and powder under the eyes, and I think that'll be you if you want that kind of look for your base. Or you can use it, which I do mostly when I do wear this. I use it underneath my foundation. Practically love it underneath the Fenty hydrating foundation, which I'll show you next, spoiler alert. And it just makes a beautiful combo. As you can tell from the bottle there, it's been well loved. I think I will be running out of the list soon, which is gonna be so sad. I mean, to have the Mila Food product, or I could just buy another like travel size, why not? And yeah, it's just a really, really good glowy, like light reflecting base primer. I love it. Like, it just makes your skin look perfected and just boosting. Now the glow is very like, obvious, but and some people might not like that, but I love that. I love a really, really good glow. Like, I love the glow. That's just me, so it is. So on to the next part, which is what I mentioned before. It is the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Foundation, the hydrating formula in the shade 300. Now I don't wear this today, I haven't got it on. I have worn in quite a few past videos from this year, which probably haven't worn enough because I'm crap at like getting them edited the one time. Hey ho. But I have these in the boxes, and this is what the actual foundation looks like. You can tell I've actually made a dent in it because I've been using it non-stop from January. Like December, I got it actually at the end of December for Christmas shopping, like Boxing Day, should I say, Boxing Day shopping. And that's what it looks like. Yeah, I can tell how skinny the top's got. It's starting to get it. It's actually crazy. And this foundation is lovely. It does give you a hydrated feel. It doesn't make your skin feel dry or anything. And it does get you medium to full coverage, which I absolutely love. I love a good high coverage foundation for like when I want to get glammed up, and even during the day if I want to just have a nice base on. Now, the exception for me not wearing like a like heavy coverage foundation is when I just want a wee glow boost on my face. It's a wee quick 5-10 minute makeup look. I won't wear a high coverage foundation, but this is actually perfect for if you're looking for that high coverage foundation. And this has a lovely olive undertone, which I think 290 has more of an olive undertone. And when I swatched this one, I was like, that is like proper olive, I'm getting that. So I bought it in Boots with my voucher, and I absolutely love it. So yeah, I would definitely recommend it. And if you know Fenty, they have loads of shades, so you're bound to find something that's gonna match you. And a lot with like a glowy booster, even the kind of like just a regular primer, goes really well. But I prefer using a glowy primer underneath that, and just makes your skin look beautiful. And because it is hydrating, it's good for like fine lines and wrinkles. I know I don't have loads of them, but the minute touch wood, touch something like Knockwood. I'll not get them for a good long while. But I am coming 30 this year, so I have to try to, like, I can't really wear a flat matte look anymore without a glowy primer underneath it lights. So this foundation's perfect for me. So, the next product, which I probably have shown you before because I've been loving it since I got it in September, it is the I Heart Revolution I Heart Chocolate Bronze and Highlight Duo. So it basically looks like that. It's all like starting to look a bit mankier now because I've been using it non-stop, and it comes with a mirror. It's like one of the Patrick Ta style products. I was like, actually expecting that to be a bronzer, but it's actually a highlight because it looked like a bronzer on the packaging. But that's what it looks like. So that is like a medium. It's in the shade medium. I think I have deep and all and light and fur, but I'll swatch that one and that one. And as you can tell, they're like beautiful colours. Like the medium bronzer, like contour, is really, really nice and dark. So it's good for like medium tan skin tones. What I got to Felix swatch, but that's what it looks like. If you can see that, that you can, but it is a good contour and highlight palette for medium to tan skin tones. I absolutely love it. It works brilliantly for my mentally fake tan skin. I'm kind of in between the doing my tan the night, but it works like reasonably well for my in between tan. Pale skin, I haven't really tried it on, so I don't think it'll really work for my pale skin. It might be too much, I think it would, but it is good for like a medium skin tone, definitely. You could get away if you ever liked the medium, but no further than that. But this is just a really, really good contour and highlight palette. I absolutely love it. Last but not least is free lip products. So the first one I'm going to talk about is a lip liner. This is the NYX Vintage, I think it's called. Vintage lip liner, and it just looks like that. Like a nice kind of rosy brown colour. And I have this on as a lip liner, like outlining and shading them lips with a lipstick on, which is one of these ones I'm going to show you. So, that's what it looks like. Like a nice like brown with a bit of berry rosiness to it. It's absolutely beautiful. Like, it's like a natural lip liner, but like it's a deeper version of a natural lip liner. So you can outline your lips, overline your lips, and shade it in, and put a lighter lip lip gloss on, and it just really blends beautifully, and it just creates that nice shape. I love it, and I think these are like £4 or £5 from NYX. You can get it from Boots and Superdrug and online. I think I'll get this from Boots anyway, and I absolutely love it. No Superdrug, I actually tell that I'm Superdrug, but I absolutely love it. So, last but not least is two lipsticks. I got these in the the Revolution Advent Calendar. And now you're thinking, if you know me, you're thinking, Brookelynne, you don't wear normal lipstick, you wear liquid lipstick. I know. And I do have one of these on, I think it's a darker one. They look so similar, it's hard to really tell them apart. But I think I have that one on. And they're basically like rosy nude colours. Let me see, I'll open that. Yeah, I think I have that one on, I think. But they're basically like nice rosy nude colours. And I just love them, they're so nice. I can't really tell you the colours because the writing's that small, but if I can. What one do they actually have on? No, I think it might be that one or the top one. But yeah, I think it is. But one's more rosy, one's more pinky in this lighting. I think I have that one on. But they just feel so nice in the lips, and they do last a good bit. Not as long as liquid lipstick, but they're good to throw on their own or on top of a liquid lipstick, because they just give you that nice like nude lip colour, like with a hint of colour. It's just beautiful. I absolutely love it. And I'll try to read the name, their makeup obsession, just lipstick Accomplishment. It's normally the cancer the name. Fuck you do. But yeah, I absolutely love these. So that was the last of my January, February 2022 beauty favourites. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope to see you again in my next videos. Stay gorgeous. God bless. Bye.